So side effects of intravesicular therapy. The patient have voiding symptoms and hemorrhagic cystitis because it is a invasive procedure. So there will be chance of inflammation. Thiotipa can reduce WBC and platelets. So we have to check these values intermittently. And regarding the BCG, it can cause flu-like symptoms or increased urinary frequency, hematuria or systemic infection. But when chemotherapy are using in intravesicular route, the other type of side effects are not seen, like nausea, vomiting, as well as hair loss. Postoperative instructions, we have to tell the patient to drink a large volume of fluid for the first week after the procedure. Teach the patient to self-monitor the color as well as consistency of the urine also. The urine will be pink for the first several days, but it should not be bright red or it should not contain blood clots. That should be properly informed to the patient. So approximately 7 to 10 days after tumor resection, the patient may observe dark red or rust-colored flecks in the urine. But after 10 days, if the patient still having these some kind of abnormality is the we have to expect like that. So administer opioid analgesic can be done along with stool softeners. Straining should be avoided. Help the patient and family cope with fears about cancer surgery as well as sexuality. His sexuality will not be affected. So emphasize the importance of follow-up, and follow-up cystoscopies are required to check whether the surgery is proper or not. And next, regarding the nursing management, similar nursing diagnosis is similar to prostate cancer. Impaired urinary elimination, pain related to chronic urinary infection, otherwise pain after surgery also can be written. Risk for metastasis, hyperthermia related to infection, or impaired skin integrity. Impaired skin integrity can be related to excoriation of the urethra. So that also can be written. So that is all about bladder cancer.